Here I've got three pictures, each of a voltaic cell, a zinc hydrogen one, hydrogen copper, and zinc copper. Now, do you know how to find out what the potential difference would be between the zinc and the hydrogen electrodes if these were standard conditions? You have that information. Do you know where to find it? And the same question applies to between the hydrogen and the copper cell. If you do know where to get this information, write it in and then try to deduce what the potential difference would be between the zinc and the copper cell. Okay, if you don't know how to do that, let me help you. Here we have a section of the standard electrode potential table. And in this table, remember, we have a series of forward and reverse reactions written one under the other such that the strongest reducing agents are found on the top right, the strongest oxidizing agents on the bottom left. And then there are a number of numbers written along the edge. What do those numbers mean? Well, let's start off with this one, 0 or 0.00, and that tells us that this particular electrode, which is the hydrogen electrode, was chosen to be the reference electrode when it's in standard conditions, under standard conditions, 1 molar concentration and at 25 degrees Celsius. So then somebody came along and using standard conditions always, they used a hydrogen electrode as one terminal and then they plugged in each of these other chemicals in turn and took a measurement of what the potential difference was, and that's what they recorded in this table. And so these values are what the potential difference would be between that chemical and the hydrogen standard electrode. So if we use the example shown here of the zinc hydrogen cell, then here we have zinc clearly being the reducing agent because it's the furthest on the top right, so it is oxidized. The hydrogen ions being the oxidizing agent because it's the furthest on the left and down, so it is reduced. And the potential difference between them must be 0.76 volts because that's what the table tells us. That's what somebody previously measured for us and wrote down on the table. And the negative value in front of that 0.76 tells us that the zinc electrode will be the negative one when it's connected to the hydrogen electrode, which obviously then must be the positive electrode. Similar situation applies to the next example that I had in my first question, the hydrogen copper cell. Again, this is simply replicating what someone did when they drew up this table for us using a hydrogen electrode and a copper electrode. And so, if you were to repeat what that person did when they set up this table using standard conditions, you would find what they found, namely that the potential difference between the two would be 0.34 volts. And the positive here means that the copper electrode here would be the positive terminal in this case, and the negative would be the hydrogen electrode. Okay, so now we have the voltage, the potential difference between the zinc and the hydrogen electrodes, and the potential difference between the hydrogen and the copper electrodes. So, what do we deduce the potential difference between the zinc and the copper electrodes to be? Try yourself before you continue with this video. Can you see that it would be 1,1 volt? The zinc electrode has a potential 0.76 volts less than the hydrogen, and the copper 0.34 volts more than the hydrogen. And so the zinc must have a potential of 1,1 volt less than the copper, 0.76 plus 0.34. To put it in a more formal manner, the standard electrode potential of the cell, so that zero up at the top, the superscripted zero is telling us standard electrode potential. And what we mean by that is under standard conditions, 1 molar and 25 degrees Celsius conditions. If that were not so, we would have to make an adjustment accordingly. But the standard electrode potential of the entire cell is found by the difference between the standard electrode potential of the cathode and the standard electrode potential of the anode. Remember, the anode is the one where oxidation happens and the cathode is the one where reduction happens. And in the case of a voltaic cell, the anode is negative and the cathode positive. So let's let's get back to this. We see here's the zinc and there's the copper ions which are going to react. The zinc is going to be oxidized to zinc ions, the copper ions reduced to copper. And so, because the zinc is being oxidized, that is the anode. Since the copper ions are being reduced, that happens at the cathode. And so we use this formula. We want to find out the standard electrode potential of the cell as a whole, meaning what would the voltage reading be, the potential difference reading be between the anode and the cathode. And we find it by the standard electrode potential of the cathode, which we read off here as plus 0.34, minus the standard electrode potential of the anode, which is minus 0.76. Be careful, that minus and that minus, two negatives, double negative makes a positive. So that means 0.34 plus 0.76. And so that's how we find the standard electrode potential of the cell as a whole.